Hi everyone, welcome to Arpita Sharma classes. This is a demo lecture on the World History course for UPSC CSE mains that has been launched via the channel membership. So now if you join the channel membership wherein we have launched the World History course for just rupees 59, you'll get to complete the entire syllabus of World History for your GS paper 1 UPSC mains exam. That's a guarantee from our side. It's a 30-day course. We are going to cover the entire syllabus, including the previous year questions and their solutions when it comes to specifically World History. The sources that we are using are class 11, 12th NCERTs, not just class 11, 12th NCERTs, also class 9th NCERT we are going to cover, wherein we have the Indian, the contemporary World 1 and Part 2 of World History. We are going to cover World History from Norman Lloyd's book also and Krishna Reddy's book also. So we are going to cover all the important sources of World History, plus we are going to cover PYQs, map based topics also we are going to cover. And we have created this course in the format of handmade notes in the from the perspective of your answer writing and also from the perspective of drawing mind maps and flowcharts in your answers. We all know that flowcharts and mind maps, they help you gain bonus marks in answer writing in UPSC. So keeping that in mind, we have created this course like this, handmade jo notes hote hain, mind maps hote hain, flowcharts hote hain, is tarike se humne is course ko design kiya hai with attractive pictures as well, so that your memory can be strengthened up. We all know that when we look at pictures, when we look at flowcharts and mind maps, we tend to keep those things in mind for a longer period of time. So keeping that in mind, we have created the notes of World History. This will be the index of this course: Industrial Revolution, French Revolution, all the important revolutions and events in World History we are going to cover. So far in the batch, we have covered the first two topics, Industrial Revolution and the French Revolution. Okay, abhi tak humne na Industrial Revolution aur French Revolution ko cover kar liya hai is course ke andar. Now today, as a part of demo lecture, I'm going to summarize the Industrial Revolution and the French Revolution, and not just French Revolution. Basically, we will focus on Industrial Revolution, and we will solve a question that came in 2019 in GS paper 1 in mains. UPSC ke 2019 ke GS paper 1 mains ke GS paper 1 mein Industrial Revolution se related question aaya tha, jisko hum solve karenge. So this is a demo lecture for World History. If you like this lecture, do join our complete World History through channel membership at just rupees 59. You are going to get the entire batch. So humne in the batch lecture 1 of this batch, we have already covered the Industrial Revolution. What is Industrial Revolution? Basically, Industrial Revolution started in England. England mein ye Industrial Revolution start hua tha. And Industrial Revolution means transition, a shift to better mode of manufacturing processes. Pehle kya hota tha? Traditional modes use hua karte the manufacturing ke liye, production ke liye. People used to put in their labor, hard work. They used to create things with their own hands. Now, with the coming of Industrial Revolution, new manufacturing processes came up because now machines were invented. And hand production decreased, machines increased, chemical manufacturing increased, iron production processes increased. And this Industrial Revolution happened somewhere around 1760 to 1840. This was the time period between which Industrial Revolution took place. Ye aapka time period tha jab puri tarike se Industrial Revolution develop hona shuru hua tha. In England it started, it spread throughout Europe and United States. And Industrial Revolution mein na water power increased, use of steam increased. Okay, steam engines were created and new machine tools were used and innovated, and factory system, previously it was a traditional factory system, now a new form of mechanized factory system came up in this Industrial Revolution. Now when we talk about Industrial Revolution, it can be studied in four phases. We will study in World History the first phase of Industrial Revolution abhi. Okay, then we in the next set of lectures in the batch, we will talk about the electric power, that is the second phase of Industrial Revolution, the third phase and the fourth phase wherein computers and digital revolution took place. But in this demo lecture, we'll study about the first phase only. If you want to study the entire syllabus of World History through this interactive manner and handmade notes, join our batch at just rupees 59. There will be a button on our channel, join. So aap us pe click karenge, to at just 59 rupees aapko पूरा वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री का बैच मिल जाएगा, सो दैट आपकी रिवीजन और अच्छे से तैयारी वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री की यही हो जाएगी. Okay, so in the first phase of industrial revolution, we used water and steam power. Okay, and there were different innovations that were made. For example, cement, Bessemer process, steam engine, flying shuttle, cotton engine, spinning jenny, telegraph, modern roads were laid down, power loom were created. These are the different kind of innovations that happened in the first industrial revolution. Earlier, we used to had before industrial revolution, we used to work on a small cottage scale, level scale industry. But now it was converted in the industrial revolution into large mechanized factory based industry. So factory system came, okay, mechanized factory system came in the industrial revolution. There were different innovations, like in 1764 James Hargreaves invented spinning jenny, Samuel Compton invented spinning mule, okay, then there was Edmund Cartwright who invented the power loom. All of these enabled people to work more efficiently and on a more speedy manner, in a you know more speedy manner. So kya ho gaya tha, बनाने का जो स्पीड थी वो बढ़ गई थी. स्पीड बढ़ जाती है तो एफिशिएंसी बढ़ जाती है, एफिशिएंसी बढ़ जाती है तो जल्दी से जल्दी वो चीज आप मार्केट में ला सकते हो, जल्दी से जल्दी आप उसको बेच सकते हो और प्रॉफिट कमा सकते हो. प्लस एम्प्लॉयमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज वर क्रिएटेड, ओके, बिकॉज इन मशीन्स को ऑपरेट करने के लिए यू नीड पीपल. ठीक है, सो एम्प्लॉयमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज वर ऑल्सो क्रिएटेड. प्लस बेसिकली द यू नो यू कैन से क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ ईज्ड डाउन, ईजी हो गया था. यहाँ पर अब खुद इंसान को अपने हाथों से इतना एफर्ट डालने की जरूरत नहीं है, सब काम मशीन्स कर रही हैं. सो हियर यू कैन सी इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन लेड टू द यूज ऑफ न्यू एनर्जी सोर्सेज लाइक पेट्रोल, कोल, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, स्टीम इंजन. देयर वर इन्वेंशंस ऑफ न्यू मशीन्स बिकॉज न्यू एनर्जी सोर्सेज आर कमिंग, सो न्यू मशीन्स वर इन्वेंटेड. For example, these are the examples of new machines. Okay, power loom, spinning mule, spinning jenny, etc. Then science, the use of science increased in the industry because new inventions are coming up. Okay, new materials, iron and steel were used. Factory system became mechanized. Employment opportunities increased. Transportation was more efficient. Okay. So there were positive impacts of industrial revolution. For example, because now factory system became mechanized, machines were used, so wealth increased, production of goods increased, quality of living increased because employment opportunities were created. Now people could, you know, purchase houses for themselves, they can switch to education, they can have better access to education, they can switch to healthier diets because they were earning good, okay, goods were cheaper, and there were, you know, inventions and there were innovations in health department also. For example, Edward Jenner, he invented a vaccine for smallpox, and new kinds of bacteria were discovered by Louis Pasteur. So in the health area also, in the medical field also, there were inventions because of new machines and new R&D, okay, research and development. But just like everything, you know, every coin has two sides, industrial revolution mein bhi there were positive and both negative impacts. Okay, har sikke ke do pehlu hote hain na, aise hi industrial revolution mein bhi do baatein thi, acche impacts bhi the to bure impacts bhi the. For example, now competition increased and because of which rivalry increased. Britain aur France ke beech mein bhi rivalry badhne lagi. Why? Because competition increased, colonies were exploited, there was a struggle for supremacy, that is why world wars happened. Okay, plus people now were, you know, more dependent on machines and there were more profit, so the factory owners used to make their laborers work for extra hours, because of which there was bad working conditions in factories, wages were less. In order to earn more profit, they used to give less wages to the laborers. Okay, so these are the negative impacts of industrial revolution also. Now based on this, let us solve one question that came in 2019 in UPSC CSE mains. Before that, here's a very important announcement for all of you. Today, that is on April 17, 2022 at 11 a.m. you will have to prepare, you will have to give or appear for the UPSC CSE Mega Combat, which is an all India free scholarship test. ये अभी सुबह 11 बजे कुछ ही घंटों में एक all India free scholarship test Unacademy conduct कर रहा है. In this test, you will stand a chance to win scholarship from a pool of rupees 10 crore. आपको 10 करोड़ की you know जो हमारा pool है उसमें से scholarship जीतने का मौका मिलेगा इस test में. Even if you just are participating, you are not getting any rank. Still, you will get chance to win exciting gadgets and gift vouchers. 500 lucky participants ko yahan par gadgets aur gift vouchers jeetne ka chance bhi milega. Plus, if you score a rank from 1 to 1000, you will win free prelims test series, jiske andar you will be given 28 tests for 2 months, that is for the upcoming prelims examination. What you need to do is you need to use this code Arpita10, click on the link which is given below and use this code and enroll. Jaldi se enroll kar lo. It is a live test going to be conducted today at 11 a.m. aap isko app pe bhi de sakte ho ya aap isko Unacademy ki website pe bhi de sakte ho. 1 ghante ka test hai, English Hindi dono languages mein available hai aur 56 questions hi hain jo aapko solve karne hain. So do not miss this test that is going to be conducted today at 11 a.m. okay, all the very best. So the question in 2015 that was asked was, why did the industrial revolution first occur in England? सबसे पहले क्वेश्चन में ये पूछा गया है कि इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन सबसे पहले इंग्लैंड में क्यों हुआ. ओके, व्हाई डिड इट अकर इन इंग्लैंड, फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन. सेकंड पार्ट इज आस्किंग डिस्कस द क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ, अंडरलाइन क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ ऑफ पीपल ड्यूरिंग इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन. दिस इज द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन. थर्ड पार्ट इज हाउ डज इट कंपेयर विद दैट इन इंडिया एट प्रेजेंट. दिस इज द थर्ड पार्ट. अगर हम इंडिया से कंपेयर करें इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन को तो क्या कंपैरिजन आप क्या यू नो कंक्लूजन आप निकालेंगे. ठीक है, सो फर्स्ट दे आर आस्किंग अस टू यू नो आंसर व्हाई इट अकर्ड इन इंग्लैंड ओनली. सबसे पहले इनिशियली व्हाई इट स्टार्टेड इन इंग्लैंड ओनली. एंड देन दे आर आस्किंग कि ड्यूरिंग द इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन फेज हाउ द लाइफ ऑफ पीपल वॉज इन यू नो ड्यूरिंग दैट फेज. एंड थर्ड दे आर आस्किंग टू कंपेयर इट विद द इंडियन इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन. ओके, समझ आ गया. तीन पार्ट से क्वेश्चन के, पहले बोल रहे हैं इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन इंग्लैंड में क्यों हुआ, फिर पूछ रहे हैं कि क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ क्या थी लोगों की उस समय, और फिर बोल रहे हैं कि अभी इंडिया में जो इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन हो रहा है उससे कंपेयर करो. ठीक है, इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन को ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम. ओके, सो लेट अस आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन. फर्स्ट यू विल बिगिन विद डिफाइनिंग व्हाट इज इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन, क्योंकि ये क्वेश्चन हो जाएगा आपका 250 वर्ड्स का. थ्री पार्ट्स है ना, 250 वर्ड्स, दैट मींस 15 मार्क्स का आपका क्वेश्चन हो गया. वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन, वेरी इजी टू यू नो गेन 15 मार्क्स इफ यू हैव स्टडीड इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन और इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन वेरी नाइसली. ओके, सो इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन फर्स्ट यू विल डिफाइन इट. I told you in the first part of the lecture only what is industrial revolution. What did I teach you? Industrial revolution was a transition to new manufacturing processes from hand production to machines, chemical manufacturing and iron production process. Right? So this is the basic starting line of your answer. See, kitna simple hai na? Sirf flow chart ke form mein humne introduction bana liya. Through this flow chart we have framed our introduction. So industrial revolution, first you will define it. It leads, it means transition or shift to new manufacturing process from hand production to machines, chemical manufacturing, iron production processes. It happened between 1760 to 1840, wherein we saw the development of machine tools and rise of mechanized factory system. Simple. आपका यहाँ पर फोर लाइंस का इंट्रोडक्शन बन गया. यू गॉट योर इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ फोर लाइंस. इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन ट्रांजिशन टू न्यू मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस फ्रॉम हैंड प्रोडक्शन टू मशीन केमिकल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग आयरन प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस. इट हैपेंड बिटवीन 1760 टू 1840 एंड इट लेड टू डेवलपमेंट ऑफ, इट लेड टू द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ मशीन टूल्स, राइज ऑफ मैकेनाइज्ड फैक्ट्री सिस्टम. ओके, दिस इज द डेफिनेशन. First four lines of introduction. Now let us answer the second part of the question. See, first part of the question. Now first part is why it first occurred in England. ये England में ही क्यों हुआ? ठीक है? So see, there are different reasons, there are different factors that led to the start of industrial revolution in England. First reason is that we all know Britain had huge number of colonies. बहुत सारी colonies थी. India was one of those colonies. India भी तो Britain की colonies का part था ना. तो Britain had huge number of colonial empire, huge number of colonies. So it had a very large colonial empire. ठीक है, ब्रिटेन का कॉलोनियल एम्पायर जो था वो काफी ज्यादा बड़ा था. ठीक है, सो इंग्लैंड वॉज एबल टू प्रोक्योर रॉ मटेरियल्स फ्रॉम कॉलोनीज एट अ वेरी चीपर रेट. इंग्लैंड के पास कॉलोनीज इतनी ज्यादा थी और एक्सप्लॉइटेड कॉलोनीज थी, तो वो वहां से चीपर रेट में रॉ मटेरियल्स प्रोक्योर कर लेता था. देन बिकॉज इट हैड सो मेनी कॉलोनीज, दैट मीन्स इट हैड सो मेनी कॉलोनियल मार्केट्स वेयर इन इंग्लैंड यूज टू सेल एंड मैन्युफैक्चर गुड्स एट अ वेरी चीपर रेट. बहुत सस्ते रेट में मैन्युफैक्चर कर लेते थे और हाई रेट पे बेच देते थे. बेसिकली पीपल ऑफ द कॉलोनीज वर फोर्स्ड टू परचेज गुड्स फ्रॉम ब्रिटेन. सेम थिंग हैपेंड इन इंडिया. हम पे दबाव डाला जाता था ना कि हम उनके प्रोडक्ट्स खरीदें, है ना. तो यहाँ पर क्या होता था कि हमारे से रॉ मटेरियल वो ज्यादा चीपर रेट्स पे खरीदते थे और अपनी कंट्री में ज्यादा रेट्स पे बेचकर मुनाफा अपनाते थे, ठीक है, एंड देन यहाँ पर वो अपने प्रोडक्ट्स को हायर रेट पे बेचा करते थे. सो देर वॉज अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ मार्केट इन इंग्लैंड एंड दैट इज वाई इट फर्स्ट स्टार्टेड इन इंग्लैंड. सेकेंड रीजन इज द बिगिनिंग ऑफ रेनेसांस एंड रिफॉर्मेशन पीरियड इन इंग्लैंड. ओके, तो इंग्लैंड में ना रिफॉर्मेशन पीरियड जो है, जो न्यू एज स्पिरिचुअल प्रोग्रेस पीरियड है और न्यू अवेकनिंग पीरियड है, वो ज्यादा जल्दी शुरू हो गया था. सो दिस पीरियड लेड टू अवेकनिंग अमंग पीपल इन यूरोप इंटेलेक्चुअली स्पिरिचुअली एजुकेशन वाइज. दे वर मच मोर इनहेंस्ड एट दैट टाइम. ओके, दे हैड एक्सेस, उनके पास पहुंच थी, रीच थी उस वक्त की वो एजुकेशन एक्सेस कर सके, रिलीजियस नॉलेज एक्सेस कर सके, इन्वेंशंस कर सके. So inventions were made by British scientists. At that time, scientific mindset also grew. इस time पर जो Renaissance और Reformation period है, कि अंधी भक्ति नहीं थी, superstitions you know नहीं थे, superstitious practices were decreasing and scientific mindset was increasing. So there were more inventions. For example you can quote invention of the spinning jenny by James Hargreaves in 1769. It led to increase in the speed of spinning. Plus, there was invention of water frame by Richard Arkwright, which resulted into stronger and harder yarn for cloth making for textile industries. So that is why also the Industrial Revolution first started in England. So these are two reasons. Coming towards the third reason, we all know that England was supreme naval power. हमें पता है ब्रिटेन की जो नेवी थी वो कितनी strong थी. Right, we know about it. We have seen battles in India and we have seen the superiority of the navy of Britain. So the when we talk about the navy and the naval power of Britain was a supreme naval power and it was able to procure raw materials from other parts of the world by the help of ships ki madad se duniya ke kisi bhi kone se wo raw materials procure kar lete the. So, and plus another reason is that the climate of England was moderate, and moderate climate is required for the textile industries. That is why textile industries also grew in England. Okay. Then next reason is that the Napoleonic wars that were being fought, they never occurred in England. So in England there was no long period of wars. There was a long period of peace. जो Napoleonic wars थे उन्होंने trade और industry, जो continental countries है उनके trade और industry को damage कर दिया था. But ये wars Britain में नहीं लड़े गए थे. So that is why there was peace in Britain, which led to the development of industrial production in England. Then another reason is the decline of feudalism. सामंतवाद खत्म हो गया था. So there were large number of unemployed peasants now. अब जमींदारी वाली system जो है वो तो खत्म हो गया है ना. तो unemployed peasants थे. And these unemployed peasants, they used to go on to search jobs. So laborers were easily available for the factories in England. Because ये unemployed peasants जो थे वो job ढूंढ रहे थे. इसलिए जो factory owners थे उनको laborers बहुत cheaply और बहुत अच्छी तरीके से मिल जाया करते थे अपनी factories के लिए. Next reason is use of charcoal and tar, because of which roads were constructed, transportation improved, so that the process of production and manufacturing and selling and distribution also improved. In 1804 we saw locomotive engine being developed by George Stephenson. James Watt ne steam engine ko develop kiya. तो इससे क्या होता है, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन बेटर होता है, तो प्रोडक्शन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सेलिंग ऑफ गुड्स ऑल्सो इनहैंस गेट इनहैंस्ड. Okay, so that's how we have answered the first part of the question, what is industrial revolution and how it first, why it first happened in England. Ye part humne answer kar diya. Now moving on to the second part of the question, discuss the quality of life of people during industrialization. So that we have already discussed. Humne industrial revolution mein pad liya hai ki positive aur negative kya impacts hue the. Okay, so the quality of life was impacted both positively also negatively also. For example, when we look at the pros, we see that there was rise of urban, there was better access to education, living conditions improved because people were making profits, transportation improved. Transportation was not only good for selling and distribution and manufacturing goods, people could connect with each other through transportation. Employment opportunities improved, and earlier there was only two sections, the upper class and the lower class. Now a new section of people came, that is the middle class. ठीक है, पहले तो सिर्फ अपर क्लास सेक्शन होता था और लोअर क्लास, मतलब एक्सट्रीम रिच एंड एक्सट्रीम पुअर. अब इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन की वजह से एक नया क्लास निकल कर आया, दैट इज मिडिल क्लास, बिटवीन, जो कि अफोर्ड भी कर सकते हैं अपने एजुकेशन को और अदर प्रिविलेजेस को, ठीक है, और वो ज्यादा गरीब भी नहीं है. बीच में बैलेंस्ड एक स्टेट ऑफ सोसाइटी केम अप. ओके, नेगेटिव इंपैक्ट वाज बिकॉज ऑफ मोर एंड मोर ग्रीड दैट वाज राइजिंग अप इन द हार्ट्स ऑफ पीपल. देयर वाज चाइल्ड लेबर, देयर वाज इनइक्वालिटी. व्हाई? बिकॉज लेबर्स वर बीइंग एक्सप्लॉइटेड. माइग्रेशन बढ़ गया जॉब सर्च के लिए. वर्किंग कंडीशंस डिटेरियोरेट होने लगी बिकॉज ऑफ द ग्रीड ऑफ मोर प्रॉफिट. वेजेस वर डिक्रीजिंग एंड पीपल वर यूज्ड टू वर्क ओवरनाइट फॉर यू नो लेस वेजेस. सो देयर वाज एक्सप्लॉइटेशन ऑफ लेबर ऑल्सो. क्योंकि जो फैक्ट्री ओनर्स हैं वो क्या करते थे, ज्यादा प्रॉफिट बचाने के चक्कर में लेबर को यू नो ओवरकाम करवाते थे, ओवरवर्क करवाते थे और उनकी वेजेस को भी कम रखते थे ताकि अपने एक्सपेंसेस कम हो सके. सो दीज वर द नेगेटिव इंपैक्ट. प्लस राइवलरी बिटवीन नेशंस बिकॉज ऑफ कॉम्पिटिशन, इंक्रीज कॉम्पिटिशन. तो लोगों के बीच में राइवलरी होने लगी, नेशंस के बीच में राइवलरी होने लगी. मोर एंड मोर कॉलोनाइजेशन इंक्रीज. ठीक है, बिकॉज ऑफ यू नो बेटर अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ मार्केट्स. ये जो बड़ी बड़ी नेशंस हैं ये कॉलोनीज ज्यादा बनाने लगे ताकि उनको चीप रॉ मटेरियल्स मिल सके. सो दिस वॉज द नेगेटिव इम्पैक्ट ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन. सो वेन वी यू नो कंपेयर दैट इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन विद द इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन इन इंडिया, सी आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस इंडिया वेंट ऑन टू सोशलिस्टिक पैटर्न ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन. हमने प्लान इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन यू नो फॉर्मेट किया और हमने सोशलिस्टिक पैटर्न को अप्रोच किया. वॉट इज सोशलिस्टिक पैटर्न? वेयर इन वी डू नॉट फोकस ऑन प्राइवेट प्रॉफिट, we focus on social gain. Here people were focusing on their private pattern in England, in Europe. ठीक है, लोग अपने private profit पे focus करते थे. In India we focused more on social gain. Okay, we focused on industrial goods, but the exploitation of working class people were less. Why? Because we had labor laws to protect their rights. Okay. So that is the comparison. उस तरीके से आप compare कर सकते हो इंडिया की इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन और यूरोप की यू नो ब्रिटेन की इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन को. So that is how you have to frame your answer when it comes to questions on industrialization or industrial revolution. Okay? So ये था आपका 2015 का UPSC का industrial revolution के ऊपर question. So if you are enrolled in these batches, you will see how we are going to practice the answer writing also. हम answer writing को भी कैसे practice करेंगे आप ये भी सीख सकते हो world history के इस batch में. It is just for ₹59. Make sure that you enroll in this batch today before this batch ends because it's only for 30 days.